Welcome students to the second lesson of basic geometrical concepts for class 6 geometry. In the previous class we did three things, mainly point, line segment and line. Today we are going to do a very short revision of those topics and then we'll continue on to our next part. So if you remember correctly, what was a point? A point was denoted by a dot in space. It was marked with a capital letter and it denotes the position of the point in space. What was a line segment? If we took a collection of points and placed them one after the other such that it had a definite starting point and a definite ending point and thus a definite fixed length, then this would have been called a line segment. From a line segment, what we get is called a line. How do we get it? If we continue to increase the line segment on both sides endlessly by adding points, it looks something like this, where our previous line segment lies like this, and this our line goes on continually. So these are the three main points that we did in our previous class. Also, if you remember, we did collinear points and non-collinear points. That is, if we consider this line, say we consider a point C on this line, then A, C, B will be called collinear points because they lie on the same line. Similarly, if we consider another point D outside the line, then A, D and B will not be collinear, hence non-collinear points, because D does not lie on the same line as A and B. I hope this is the part where you have understood. Today we will go on to the next part, that is discussion of pair of lines. So our second part today will be pair of lines. One small thing that we did not do in the last class, which I will include under this heading, is called a ray. What is a ray? We considered a fixed point, say x, and we continue to add points to one side of it. That is, it goes on increasing on one side. Like we know sun's rays and light rays, it has a fixed starting point and it goes on endlessly, but in only one direction. As a line goes in two different directions, both sides, but a ray goes only in one direction. Okay, so x is the starting point, also called the initial point of the ray, and it goes on endlessly. Next, what we are going to do under pair of lines, the first topic under pair of lines are called intersecting lines. What do we mean by intersecting lines? Two lines such that they meet at one point and one point only are called intersecting lines. For example, I'll draw them now. Consider this straight line. We mark it A, B. Consider another straight line like this. We mark it C and D. These two lines meet at a point, a single point, say X. Hence, A, B and C, D are intersecting lines. A, B and C, D are intersecting lines. Once more, two lines, two different lines meet at a single point, then it will be called intersecting lines. And the point of intersection is X. So what is capital X called here? Capital X here is called the point of intersection. This is the first topic. Always, whenever you are drawing lines, make sure that your pencils are sharpened and make sure that the labeling is perfect. In our next part, we are going to deal with discuss parallel lines. What are parallel lines? Two such lines, or why only two? Two or more such lines, such that they never meet. They can go on extending to infinity, but they never meet each other, are called parallel lines. So therefore, parallel lines are those lines who do not have any points of intersection. For example, we draw a line, say A, B. Always in geometry, label your figures. Howsoever insignificant the figure may be, always label your figures. A line parallel to this would look something like this, labeled as C, D. Now, since we are calling them lines, we can extend them endlessly. These two are parallel lines, that is, even if we go on extending them on both sides indefinitely, they'll never meet. That is, the distance between them is a constant distance. This distance between them is a constant distance, and it will never increase or reduce. Okay, these two lines are called parallel lines. A third line drawn to this parallel line say EF. If EF is parallel to CD, EF will automatically be parallel to AB. How do we denote parallel lines? We first say the line AB is parallel to the line CD. Then we say CD is parallel to EF. That will automatically imply AB is parallel to EF. So therefore, this is a set of parallel lines. Again, like the previous ones, we can extend this line indefinitely and they'll never meet. Now the next part. So we did two parts up till now. That is, number one is the intersecting lines and number two is the parallel lines. Next thing that we are going to do here Part C are called perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines. What are perpendicular lines? Two lines will be called perpendicular lines when they have a single point of intersection and the angle between those two lines is 90 degree or a right angle. Those two lines will be called perpendicular lines. We shall better understand this with the help of the diagram. This is one line, say X, Y. If we want to draw a line perpendicular to this, say this is AB, then XY is perpendicular to AB, and similarly AB is perpendicular to XY. How do we denote it? We write the line XY is perpendicular to the line AB, or the line AB is perpendicular to the line xy. They mean the same thing. Now, this line segment AB and the line segment xy has only one point of intersection, which is B. So therefore, the point of intersection is marked as B. To recapitulate, XY is a line segment, AB is another line segment. This set of lines will be called a perpendicular lines when they are at right angles to each other and having only one point of intersection. Which is the right angle here? This is the right angle here, or 90 degree. If that is another 90 degree, then this is also a 90 degree. We'll discuss about angles and their values more in the next chapter, but for now, this is what we need to know about perpendicular lines. The next part and the last part of today will be called concurrent lines. C-O-N-C-U-R-R-E-N-T. Concurrent. C-O-N-C-U-R-R-E-N-T. Lines. What are concurrent lines? Two or more lines will be called concurrent if they pass through the same point. That is, they are intersecting lines but more in number and having only one point of intersection. For example, say I draw this line and I label it A, B. I draw another line, I label it C, D. I draw a third line through this point of intersection and I name it X, Y. So as you can see, there exists only one point of intersection, that is we mark O. For three or more line segments passing through the same common point, then that set of lines will be called concurrent lines. So therefore, we say that the line segment AB, the line segment XY, and the line segment CD are concurrent lines. And here, O is the point of intersection. So, an important thing to derive from these is that all perpendicular lines and concurrent lines are intersecting lines. Why? Because they do intersect each other at a single point. But it is not the reverse way around. Okay? So therefore, for example, we can say that when we draw perpendicular lines, they intersect at a point, say O, but these are not concurrent lines. Why? Because there are only two lines that can be perpendicular with each other at a single point of time, not more than two. So therefore, perpendicular lines may be intersecting lines, but they cannot be concurrent lines. Up to this, we'll finish this lesson. Your lesson plans will follow and your worksheets will follow. Go through the book, go through these topics, practice drawing the different types of lines, and in the next class, we shall continue this chapter to whatever is left. And I hope you're doing this all on your own. Make sure that your pencils are sharpened and your geometry box is with you. You are using your rulers and your pencils and erasers. Thank you. We shall meet again in the next class.